That's what I said, already US and AP smart city project in Visakhapatnam. And this is one more project, AP FiberNet. This comes under the Government of India NOFN project, National Optic Fiber Network project. But we are going something beyond that. Whereas they want to lay the cable up to the Gram Panchayat. But our CM asked us to work out in detail so that we could able to give 15 to 20 Mbps connectivity to each household in the rural as well as in the urban area. At an affordable price, that is also around 150 to 200 rupees per month. And 1 to 10 Gbps for all business. So this already we made the DPR. Once today presentation to the PM is over, we'll submit DPR. PwC is working with us in preparing the DPR. It's almost a 5,000 crore project. So here also we will involve the private industry, and we already formed the AP Fiber Grid Corporation, and we will formulate AP Digital Corporation. So AP Fiber Corporation will lay the fiber related electronics, everything, whereas the Digital Corporation will give you the content. So it's a big project. It's we are planning maybe by next 6 months we will start and finish it in the next 30 months, 2.5 months. It's a great challenge. It's not easy. It's a great challenge. But definitely with our guidance and support given by Honorable CM, we'll be able to do it. And again, the data center. So whatever data center now it is located in Hyderabad, finally it will go to Telangana. So we have to construct a new data centers in the new capital. So we are going for a Tier 4 data center with the latest technologies and capacities. Coming to electronics, this is where these are the given indications given. What is the present status in 2014 and 15? What could be the demand for all these electronic items by 2019-20, there will be a huge gap. So these all are coming from imports. Of now, as per the call given by our Honorable PM, that is Make in India. So this gap, we have to fill it up. There, I think, already all electronic industry is concentrating, and we have to bridge that gap. There will be a lot of demand. Basically, as you know, telecom equipment, laptops, desktops, tablets, LEDs, smartphones, set-top boxes, medical electronics. These are the fields where they contribute 80% of the demand. Then coming to the our human capital, that is the talent pool available in the Andhra Pradesh. There is no doubt whenever any competitive examinations are taking place like IIT, IIM, the top rankers and the number of the candidates being selected from Andhra are the highest. In the United AP also, we are the toppers. So similarly, this is the degree colleges, either government and private, engineering colleges, either government and private put together. We are having 1,525 colleges producing 5,560 students annually. They may be MCA, MBA, other degrees and engineering. So pool is, talent pool is available. We have to make use of them. These are some of the interventions which we asked the higher education department to inculcate the culture of innovations in the early stages. So these are some things we are working out. And this is the proposed infrastructure. We have sent a DPR to Government of India to give the IT investment regions in Visakhapatnam, Tirupati and Anantapur area. And electronic manufacturing clusters, we are aiming at 20, but we may limit to some strategic points. So already Sri City, I told you, and Elsina in Anantapur. And electronic hardware park one and signature tower, I already told you, we are constructing in Vizag, SEZ area. Infrastructure presently available. This is the startup village which we have constructed in Vishakhapatnam, that Rishikendra area. There we have already started. Within the 6 months, we got around 104 startups are functioning actively in that. And we have provided a 1 GB, 1 GB connectivity also, which is not heard of, because providing that much so that the speed will be good and the students and startups will utilize that connectivity. And the space-wise, that one, and the land-wise, we are having the Gambiram IT Park, Madhravada IT layout, and Kapalupada. There we are proposing around 200 to 300 acres to come up as the new IT layout. Coming to the office locations, private space is also available. VSEZ is there in Vizag, opposite steel plant. There also around 1 lakh square feet space is readily available. So this is the Vijayawada Medha Towers. This is constructed by L&T Medha Towers. Here also around 1.1 million square feet land is total plant space. But now already available is around 2 lakh built up area is there, 2 lakh square feet. So those who are coming, entrepreneurs, we are asking them to take the space in this already built up area available. In Vijayawada also, opposite Gannavaram, we are taking around 200 acres of the land for future needs of the IT as well as the electronic. And this is the Sri City in Chittur and Nellore districts, which is very near to the Chennai. Chennai, and here SEZ as well as non-SEZ is there. Almost 100 units they have already functioning there, out of which some are operational, some are under construction. So they are from almost 10-15 countries. Majority of them are from Japan, Isuzu and other things. Here also, it is a very big SEZ, one of the successful SEZ. Its area is around 5,000 acres. So a lot of land is available for establishing electronic and other related industry. This is the EMC at Anantapur. This is approved by the Government of India. Those people are also here. They will also explain you. To start, they want 7 entrepreneurs. Now they have already made MOUs with 5 entrepreneurs. They are in search of other 2 entrepreneurs so that they can start the process there. This is also very near to the Bangalore airport. That is the advantage, Bangalore airport. So these are all the things from our state. Our Honorable Minister also will enlighten you on other things. So with this, I request all of you to revisit Andhra Pradesh again. We are always here. We will cooperate with you with a proactive bureaucracy is there. All officers are tuned to work with the private industry. We are always available. So once again, I request all of you to establish your development centers or any other centers. In fact, we last March we went to US and interacted with Oracle and other HP. We went to their headquarters and we have interacted. And in the next month again, CM is also visiting US. Already he visited Japan, China, Singapore and Davos. So he is requesting, so you made the Hyderabad a successful city. So our Honorable CM, already you know the capital region is coming up at Amaravati. So Singapore is helping us in preparing the master plan. So he is concentrating one side on the establishment of our capital and then establishment of the industries, both normal industries, IT industry, IT related and electronic industry. And there is a lot of opportunities on the seaports, airports. There is a lot of infrastructure, it will come up in the state. So on behalf of our Honorable CM and Honorable Minister, I once again request to revisit Andhra Pradesh and establish your units in Andhra Pradesh. Thank you. Thank you.